The Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 14th chapter. Immediately after feeding the 5,000, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead to the other side, while Jesus dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up the mountain by himself to pray. And when evening came, he was there alone. But by this time the boat, battered by the waves, was far from the land, for the wind was against them. And early in the morning, Jesus came walking toward them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost!" And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." And Jesus said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat and started walking on the water and came toward Jesus. But when he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened and began to sink. And he cried out, "Lord, save me!" And Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to Peter, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" But when they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshipped Jesus, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of our Lord. I have a confession to make. I had an entire sermon written about this text. I was going to talk about how we need to get out of the boat because the boat is sinking and we need to keep our eyes on Jesus in the midst of struggle and terrible things, and that when the boat is sinking and things are changing, it's when we are able to get out and focus on Jesus. And I had this whole thing worked up. And then I read another article as I was preparing to preach, and I realized I was wrong. Maybe not wrong in some interpretations of the text, but I realized that what I was going to say is not what most of us need to hear right now. Because I was going to be a cheerleader and an encourager and say, you know, we got to look to Jesus. We got to trust in Jesus. We got to believe in Jesus so we don't sink down. And that's something we need to do. But the truth is, I think most of us know that. I think we know that we need to keep our eyes on Jesus, and we need to know, we know that we need to find our strength from Jesus. But I don't think that we always need to hear that. Like Jesus is some kind of personal trainer, or I'm a personal trainer telling you to do that. And that Jesus is there as a life coach to help you out when you have troubles, and when you don't, just keep looking and he'll cheer you on. Because I don't need a life coach or a personal trainer from my Savior. What I need is not to be told what I ought to be doing when I have little faith. I need one who's going to reach out and grab me. What's going on in this text? Peter is in the boat. It's being rocked and rolled and turned around, and they see Jesus coming, and he's scared, but he is willing to get out of the boat. He is willing to take those steps. He is willing to trust Jesus. But when he gets out, it overwhelms him. The whole experience, everything that's happening, it overwhelms him. And he begins to sink down. We are like that, especially now in this time. I mean, we all have good weeks and bad weeks, and it depends on what it is, but the uncertainty in this unprecedented time is so hard. because we know that Jesus is going to take care of it, and we know that we need to trust in God, and we know that we need to believe. But sometimes, whether it's the uncertainty of not knowing what's going to happen to us economically, or the loneliness, or the fear of the disease, or what's going to happen when winter comes, or all the changes, or everything that's been totally thrown up in our lives and gone in a billion different directions, sometimes it just gets to be too much. And so we start to sink down. We know we need to look to Jesus. We know that Jesus will take care of us. But treading water is hard at times. I can relate to Peter, because try as I might, in the midst of my own struggles and in the midst of my own pain, sometimes it just gets to be too much. And I take my eyes off Jesus, and I look at myself, and I get scared. We all do. And if we aren't saying that, then we're not being honest with ourselves, because in order to believe strongly, you need to know what doubt and struggle is. And I think that this text, rather than telling us to be like Peter and get out of the boat, but don't be like Peter and take our eyes off Jesus, makes it all about what we have done and what we are doing. And like I said, right now, I need someone to grab me, to hold on to me. We need someone to lift us up, because we are not strong enough. We are not able, but Christ is able to do far more than we ever expect or imagine by reaching out and being a savior. It's not about my strong faith or about your strong faith. It is about a God who reaches out and gives us grace and who gives us life. The focus of this story is not on Peter or the rest of the disciples who didn't even get out of the boat and it may have been sinking. It is on Jesus, who reaches out and lifts up Peter, who is drowning, and then gets in the boat with the rest of the disciples who haven't even left the boat. And he gives them peace and calm. If you've ever had that experience where you've been somewhere and you've almost fallen and someone's grabbed you. You know, I remember once when I was on a hike with my family, and I tripped, and I was, could have been a very bad fall, but one of my sisters grabbed me and kept me from falling. And that kept me from possibly having a really bad accident. If you've ever had that experience, you know what it's like to have someone hold on to you, to keep you from falling. And that's what Jesus does for us. A love that will not let us go, that will reach out even when we fail, even on those bad days, even when we struggle. God will not let us go, because God will hold on to us. We do need to strengthen our faith. We do need to be willing to get out of the boat. But ultimately, we know that it's not about us. It's about the one who walks to us in the midst of the storm, and who calms our hearts and our souls and gives us peace, who speaks to us in a still, small voice, who is there, who does not let us drown. Though I am overwhelmed, Christ holds on to us through life into death, into life again, because nothing can separate us from the love of God. Nothing can keep us from that. You know the song, Precious Lord? It's written by Tommy Dorsey. And he wrote that song after his wife had died in childbirth. And then the baby that was born died a short time later. And he was tired, he was weak, and he was worn. Through the pain, he knew the precious Lord would take his hand and not leave him and lead him home. So the message today, a message I think we all need to hear during these challenging times, is if you're having a good week, that's wonderful. Keep looking to Jesus, strengthening your faith, and knowing that when you trust and follow Jesus, God will give us the tools that we need. But if you're feeling like you're sinking down, like it's just too much, like you can't bear it anymore with your last breath, it's not up to you, because Jesus will reach out. He will lift you up. He will make you whole. Ultimately, that's the promise of the gospel. Today, we don't need to hear what we should be doing. We need to know what Jesus has already done. And that is good news in an uncertain time. He has reached out, he has taken our hand, and he will lead us through this life and ultimately home. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night trust me, and the day is past and gone. At the river I stand, guide my feet, hold my hand. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.